this week, we want to show you how to make some triple sauce rice rolls or 混酱肠粉. That's a classic Cantonese street snack that's made with a type of rice noodle that's called 猪肠粉 or pork intestine noodles. They're called that way not because they contain any pork or intestine, but mostly because they kind of look like one. But before we start, let's lay some groundwork. I am a rice noodle fundamentalist. Rice noodles should just be about rice. You should be able to taste the subtle flavors in rice noodles itself, and you should also be able to just appreciate the different characteristic textures for different kinds of rice noodles. But nowadays, unless you are eating at a very tasty store or restaurant that got its own specific supply for rice noodles, the rice noodle quality in Guangdong tends to be pretty disappointing. Like, look at this 猪肠粉 we get at our local market. See how it's kind of translucent and gets transparent as you heat it up? This is just garbage. In the past decade, it seems like this kind of garbage 猪肠粉 has taken over. That's the kind that's made with way too much added starches, it's way too slippery, it doesn't sustain longer cooking time, and it honestly tastes like plastic. So today, let's revive the tradition and make some round rice noodle rolls from scratch using just rice. So we'll need 200 grams of dry rice. Here we have 100 grams of short grain jinjumi from the northeast. You can also just use sushi rice. And to that, we are gonna add another 100 grams of jasmine rice for some extra fragrance. You can also just use 200 grams of straight up sushi rice or jasmine rice. I tested them all and they all work, just with a slight textural and flavor difference. Now give the rice a rinse, submerge it with water and soak it for 4 hours or alternatively overnight in the fridge. Then once your rice is soaked, we can make our batter. Strain the rice first, and now we'll need to see how much we are working with. So get your blender on a scale, tear, toss the rice and see how much it weighs. Usually the rice would absorb about 50 grams of water, and as you can see, ours is a little bit more than 250 grams. So now add more water till it reaches 500 grams. Next, blend on high for 4 minutes. Scrape them if needed. Once the batter is all smooth, pour into a bowl and set aside. So, steaming setup. Here we have our steaming wok, a rack, and an 8x8-inch non-stick baking tray. Traditionally, people would use bamboo trays to make this and it creates a thinner result, but you probably don't own one of this, so baking tray it is. So, bring enough water to a heavy boil. Preheat the tray for a minute. While it's preheating, add in 2 grams or half a teaspoon of peanut oil to the batter. Mix well, and now we are ready to steam. Take out the tray, lightly brush some oil on, and stir the batter to make sure nothing settles at the bottom. Now, scoop some batter to your tray, just enough to spread over the surface. Put the tray in, make sure it's not tilted. Cover, steam on high for 2.5 minutes. It will be done once you can see big bubbles forming underneath the rice noodle sheet, then take out your tray. Now we can roll. Use a bench scraper, gently lift the far end off the sheet, flip the edge over, and roll it with the help of the bench scraper till you reach the closed end. Take it out and then set aside. Now work through your batter. This recipe uses about 7 to 8 rice rolls with an 8x8-inch baking tray. I know this may seem a little complicated, so for a clearer version, you can check out the uncut shots up here. Soft, slightly chewy, with some delicate rice fragrance, just like how a 猪肠粉 should be. So right, now we have noodles ready, let's show you how to make the classic street snack. This snack is literally rice rolls smothered in 3 sauces. The 3 foundational sauces are a peanut butter sauce, a seasoned soy sauce, and a sweet and savory sauce called sweet sauce, or often Hoisin. More on that in a sec. But now, let's show you how to whip those up. So peanut butter first. The peanut butter sauce in this dish is a fried one. So let's break out our wok. First, 浪油. Get your wok piping hot. Shut off the heat. Add in the oil. Here we are using 2 tablespoons of quality peanut oil. Some stores would use lard in this process to give it a richer flavor. So it's totally up to you. And then toss in 2 tablespoons of natural peanut butter. Heat on low. And patiently mix it till smooth. Once the color deepens a little bit, shut off the heat and take it out. Next, season soy sauce. This is actually a product that you can just buy at most Chinese supermarkets. And they are often labeled as like seasoned soy sauce or seasoned soy sauce for seafood or something like that. But making it is also very easy. Just combine 2 tablespoons of soy sauce, 2 tablespoons of water, 2 teaspoons of sugar into a tiny saucepan. Heat on low, bring it to a boil, and let it cook for a minute. Then heat off, set aside. Finally, let's tackle the sweet sauce. If you're in Guangdong or Hong Kong, you can just buy a pack of this and squeeze it onto your rolls. It's a sweet and savory sauce that tastes quite like hoisin, which is actually a really common choice for vendors too, only this one has a very slight hint of fruitiness. So you can totally just use hoisin here, but if you like, you can also just sub this sweet sauce by simply mixing half hoisin and half part of the Thai sweet chili sauce. But this is a really free thing. Some shops use house make, some shops use this Thai sweet chili sauce, and we even tested with Trader Joe's chili jam for the sake of completeness, and they all work great. So now we have everything ready. Let's serve. Zhichuanfeng is often served warm. Some shops will keep it in a steamer. Some shops will give it a pan fry to create a nice little crust. And today we are going the steaming route. So quickly steam your rice roll on high for 3 minutes. Take it out. On a plate with some wax paper for extra authentic points, cut 4 rolls into about 1-inch sections with a pair of scissors. Pour on 2 tablespoons of the fried peanut butter sauce, 2 tablespoons of seasoned soy sauce, a couple tablespoons of those sweet sauce or hoisin, sprinkle on some toasted white sesame seeds, and now your triple sauce rice rolls are done. Just like how you get from a good place from the street. So right, I know using sugaring rice sounds pretty counterintuitive for rice noodles, but that's the beauty for all kinds of different rice products. They all have their unique characteristics that shouldn't just be ruined by this one better fits all kind of approach. So right, check out the recipe in the description box. A big thank you for everyone that's supporting us on Patreon. And of course, don't forget to subscribe for more Chinese cooking videos.